Wanda Johnson was 27 years old when she and some 1,400 other Kaiser Permanente members enrolled in the CARDIA study 30 years ago through Kaiser Permanente's Division of Research in Oakland. CARDIA's goal is to study the development of cardiovascular risk and disease beginning in young adults. Johnson is one of about 1,000 original participants who are expected to return to Oakland for a ninth round of exams. In all, more than 5,000 black and white men and women aged 18 to 30 were originally recruited for the study in Oakland, Birmingham, Alabama, Minneapolis, and Chicago.
This was somewhat revolutionary, I think, at the time. This was the first and really the only large study that has looked at young adults in this way and followed them all the way into middle-aged life. It was unique at the time for the inclusion of women and African Americans.
There were a lot of studies at that time on middle-aged Caucasian men, and to be a young African American female, it just seemed interesting.
150s, okay. CARDIA participants are now 48 to 60 years old, and like most Americans, they've put on some weight. During the first 25 years of the study, participants gained more than 30 pounds on average. In addition to being weighed and measured this year, study participants will have their blood pressure, glucose, and cholesterol tested. They'll be interviewed extensively about lifestyle factors such as alcohol and tobacco use, diet and exercise, and medical and family history.
And hold your breath.
This year's testing also includes an echocardiogram to measure the structure and function of the heart.
Things are happening to the heart at this age because of risk factors like hypertension and diabetes. For some people, we are seeing the stages of heart failure developing.
CARDIA has produced important findings on health disparities. Over the years, black women and men have developed diabetes at a faster rate than white participants. The same is true for high blood pressure. And over the first 20 years of the study, 26 black participants developed heart failure, while only one white participant did. The vast majority of those with heart failure had high blood pressure early in life.
The fact that over 1% of African Americans had heart failure by age 40 is really an important finding. This study really does help us to think about how better to prevent some of the diseases that are really the leading causes of death in the United States.
There have been more than 600 papers published in scientific journals using data from the CARDIA study. One of the most important findings is that cardiovascular disease develops over a lifetime.
Risk factors measured early in life, such as blood pressure and blood cholesterol, and lifestyle decisions, such as eating a healthy diet and physical activity, and whether or not you smoke, are major predictors of damage to the arteries that leads to heart attacks and strokes. The decisions you make about what you do early in life make a big difference in your health later in life.